Welcome to the first session of the webinar series Indigation, jointly organized by the Department of Microbiology and the Research Committee of Indian Academy Degree College Autonomous. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the resource person, Dr. Vinod Kumar. Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, ma'am, we can hear you.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce the resource person, Dr. Vinod Kumar, who is an SERB National Postdoctoral Fellow, ICAR, National Institute of Veterinary Epidemiology and Disease Informatics. Dr. Vinod did his master's in applied microbiology at VIT University, Vellore, Tamil Nadu. He then did his PhD in microbiology in the ICMR Regional Medical Research Center, which is a WHO collaborating center for diagnosis, reference, research, and training in leptospirosis, which is the National Leptospirosis Reference Center, Port Blair. He then did a short postdoc in the same place where he did his PhD, following which he joined as an assistant professor at the microbiology department of our college, Indian Academy Degree College. As he wanted to pursue research, he applied for the prestigious competitive fellowship, the SERB National Postdoctoral Fellow, which is also called the NPDF, and was awarded a grant of 22 lakhs. He pursues his NPDF at the ICART, National Institute of Veterinary Epidemiology and Disease Informatics, which is also called NEVEDI. He is also a reviewer in many journals such as Microbial Drug Resistance, International Journal of Energy and Water Resources, Journal of Comparative Human Biology, and Exposure and Health. He has also published 35 publications in both international and national journals, one book chapter, three manuals, and participated in 19 oral and poster presentations. We are very happy to have you here, Dr. Vinod, to discuss on the topic of the webinar, the title which is very catchy, The Craft of Research by Decolonizing Through Grounded Theory. I request Dr. Vinod now to take over the session. Dr. Vinod.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, we do.
Thank you, Dr. Prashanti, ma'am. Actually, we miss our conversations during my college time. For those of you who don't know, I was a part of Indian Academy Degree College during, I think, 2017 to 18. Then I had been teaching in the college. Then I have moved to pursue my higher dream, that is to do a postdoc in my research topic and interested topic, which I had a great opportunity, which was given by the Institute NIVEDI to work on my favorite research topic, that is leptospirosis. And I am also grateful to Dr. B. Balamurugan, who is my current mentor for the postdoc for this, which I am working here. So, for the postdoc project, which I am working here. So, initially, Madam has appreciated the topic, but that topic is not given by me. Actually, it was, I have very simply given the topic like how to write a literature review or a review article, basic tools and techniques which can be used. This excellent work is done by, I think, Professor Rajarajan, sir. yes, used his in-depth knowledge of a language and made it very perfect and sounding very catchy. I'm grateful to that. And those of you who don't know, Professor Rajarajan sir was also my HOD during my BSc times. So actually he inspired us to go further, do MSc and do a PhD and research work. So I think we are four or five people who have got inspired by him and got into the research field, because he saw his unique way of teaching and a unique way of expressing that I will never forget, and I appreciate his contribution in my life, and I'm grateful to that. Okay, so coming to the topic, I will share my screen now. I think this is full screen.
Down, you can see.
Yeah. Air screen.
Air screen. At the bottom. You can see share screen at the bottom.
Yeah.
A green colored icon. Yeah.
Yeah. One second. Excuse me for this. Are you able to see the full screen?
Not yet. One moment.
Now?
Yes.
Thank you. That is great. Yeah. Now you can see the presentation more full screen?
Yes. We can see.
Oh, thank you. So when I was contacted by the organizer of this seminar, and Dr. Shiba Madam, she was telling me to, because she is also my colleague, and she knows about me very well. So she has, because she knows that I'm somewhat good at literature review and something like that. So she has contacted me to present this seminar. So initially I was skeptical, because I thought it is only to scientific community, means I was doing the science-based research. And when she is told Principal Dr. Jerome Javier is interested to involve all the faculties, and it has gone to national level. I think many participants are from different states of the India. So I was a little skeptic about the topic, what to involve, because science in the research field, particularly speaking in life science, I am well versed and know about the nooks and corners about how to go about approach research and how to write a review, how to search article. So I was skeptic about how this would applicable to other fields, like I was told commerce field is involved, commerce faculties are involved, and other departments like nursing and other humanities streams are involved. I was thinking did some research on net. So I felt it is not that much difference. It is almost similar. So an academic research article is very almost similar to in all the field. So I was happy about it, and that I can contribute and make some useful discussion, so that other people also, other departments people also can utilize this in whatever way they want it. So let me start the presentation. So we are talking about literature review here. So we are not talking about writing a scientific article. So first of all, I will tell you that this presentation is regarding the writing a literature review or a research literature review article, or a, otherwise called a review article. Okay, there are some there are many categories of writing a review article, which may be simple review, narrative review on a particular topic, on current trends, or doing a systematic review, which will critically analyze the data in the published literature and present it in a statistical manner. And there is more deeper review is called meta-analysis, which involves higher levels of statistics, which will enable readers to understand the statistical viewpoint of a particular topic. Whether, so for example, this drug is working for some disease or not, or this intervention is working for the particular outcome or not. In that way, the meta-analysis is important. Today, as I was told, that participants are there are very few professor level participants, and mostly other participants are in assistant professor level faculties of the universities and colleges, and other even I think so, some of the PhD scholars are also involved in this webinar, and MSCs who are doing their master degree. So I have made it very simple. It is not a, it is, it will be a introductory approach to writing a review article. It is not a very complicated way. Prepare this so that who are listeners who can understand this concept of review article in a very easy manner, so that they can write a review article based on whatever points given here. So let me start. If a review, science cannot be done without seeing back. Means this statement is very standalone statement. It is very clear that it is by standing on the shoulders of giant that we see further. Means without the previous work, we cannot go further in the research. Okay. We need to know what has been done, and what is the knowledge gap, and based on the knowledge gap, the research is done further. So in that way, it is a great quote, and I think it is given by Isaac Newton. I think most of the literature review presentations will have this. So I have taken this from most of the literature review, which I have gone through in earlier stages. So next is, what is a review article? It is very basic understanding of a review article. It is not writing a complex review article. It is how we structure. This presentation will contain what is review article, why we are doing it, or what is the techniques involved in it, what we should not do, what are the myths around the review articles, and possibly encourage our faculties to not to hesitate and write boldly. Even if it is not a very complex review article, but they can start writing it. So this presentation, I guess, will give some sort of idea what is a review article. Okay, so let me, by definition, what is a review article? A review article is also called the literature review. So literature review is what are published literature in the print or online platforms. So previous researchers have done a lot of research on different topics, which can be which in your interest. Actually, you are checking this literature review on the topics what you are interested in. So literature in that context, literature review is also called a literature review. It is a survey of previously published research on a topic. It should give an overview of a current thinking on the same theme. And unlike the original research article, won't present a new experiment result. This is nothing to do with doing a new experiment, okay, or doing a new research. This is compilation of a review of a previous research which have been already done. So in this, we need not do a research or experiment to prove or something. It is purely based on the literature review. Means you can go through the online or print-based publications and on the topic which you are interested in, and make some sense of it, out of it on the current trend and what are the knowledge gaps, so that it can be useful for a future research topic. Okay, the objective of the literature review is to provide a critical evaluation of data available from existing studies. Review articles can be identify potential research areas to explore next, or sometimes they will draw a new conclusion from the existing data. So few points about the review articles. It provides a comprehensive foundation on a topic. It explains the current state of knowledge, identifies gaps in existing studies for potential future research, highlights the main methodology and research techniques. So when I was discussing with Madam Sheba, Dr. Sheba, on this what will be I'll be presenting in this review. So I was told this Dr. Principal sir is very much interested into encourage faculties into writing a review articles. So I feel teachers have an innate ability of literature. They are innate rich literature review because they go through so much to present to teach. They have to go through public different books and all. They always do it. So knowingly or unknowingly, they are doing a literature survey. So they are digging into different books or online platform to collect information so that they can present it in the best way so that students can understand the topic or a concept. So I feel that teachers are innate literature reviewers. So teachers who are feeling that it is difficult and feeling it is very strange thing to do a literature review or publishing. They think it is not possible to publish a literature review, or they have so much skeptic about the publishing literature review. But I'm going to tell them that it is not the case. Actually, every teacher is having the ability to write a literature review because you are already doing it unknowingly. So don't feel reluctant in approaching this. So my presentation will be to make it very simple how to write a literature review. So literature writing, review article is about more sizing on an interesting topic and gathering relevant reference. This is not the literature review is not a list. Okay, something we need to understand that literature review simply not a list like that. We go into the collect references and make a list about what is what. and it doesn't fulfill the concept of review writing. A review article should be more than just some of its parts. Readers should learn something that they couldn't get just by reading references. So when you read the titles of different article, you get somewhat idea about what is going in that article or what is about these articles. That should not be your point simply listing out the topic in the literature review. Therefore it should make sure to include a point of you including a comparison, critique, and assessment of a study you are reviewing, or your ideas for a future experience. It should give some idea about what is the knowledge gap, or what is some critical analysis about what is said in different publication what you have reviewing. So, and you should be able to conclude something so that it will be useful for a reader to go further or to understand a topic. So it is also opportunity for you to contribute to the development of your field. So indirectly, you are, by reviewing literature, you are telling something new, which will sometimes it will help future researchers or young researchers to take up the study and take up your literature review and find out what can be done in future. A good literature review can end up becoming a definitive go-to guide on a topic, forming the backbone of a reading list and appearing as a reference in countless books and articles. If your literature review is very good, so it will become inspire a lot of researchers to cite your work in their work, so that because it gives a holistic view about a topic. So they will always cite your literature in their future work, which will make it will give that your literature review will be used further for many years. I have seen few literature very old which have been used in a citation till now. Means it is having a so much importance that its value is so much important that it is being still used in this modern era. Okay. Yet the key elements of a compelling review are still a mystery for many researchers, especially those in early stages. Most of you in a professor level or assistant professor level already have done all. They have published many articles and many. They have might have written literature review in their theses, and maybe they have published many reviews also. So they are having some idea about how to write a literature review and where to search and how to find and how to frame and structure. But who are in early stage career, suppose it is a PhD scholar or a faculty who have joined recently and is starting to do research and starting to write a proposal. So for them, it is very much mystery about how to approach the literature review, how to write a literature review, and how to collect search article. All these they're not aware of. So next, moving on to next. So coming about where do we find this literature review? We find this in a journal article. There are so many journal, thousands of journal article in different fields. So there you can publish your literature review article so that it have a larger audience, so that people from different countries, different state can view your article and utilize those article in their study to gain knowledge about the particular concept. So when you're writing a literature review, so it is always better to have a proposal review. Okay, so maybe a one-page review about the concept, detailing about what you will be doing in the research and what you will be doing in this review and what will be your target audience. If you write in that way and give it and send it to some editors, so to different journals, they will give you it will be you will get more idea about the literature review what you are going to write. So suppose you, after writing a complete review, you are sending to some journal and they are not interested in publishing your review, means it will waste you a lot of time. So if you having a concept about writing a review, and if you are able to write, suppose an abstract about what you are going to be writing in the review, you can always send it to an editor of the journal and get opinion, or you can give it to your mentor or your supervisor or your HOD to look at it once, whether it is you can go further in reviewing this, whether it is a suitable topic or to write a review, whether people will be interested in your review. All this you will come to know by showing your abstract to somebody who are having more experience at it. So having a clear idea in mind about the structure you want for your article is very important. Starting with the outline and knowing exactly how you want to lead your readers through your narrative, being aware that there should be a flow in your writing. So you should be aware that what is the journey, how the concept evolved, or how a background, giving a ample background information about your research topic. Okay, so it is important to manage readers' expectation early. Sometimes you find sometimes it is better to give a, it is actually, it is always better to give a in a one or two sentence about what your what the audience is going to expect from your review. So suppose so what is different from the existing, what you are going to review in your review article. So if you give in abstract itself, so people will come to know that you are reviewing this kind of topic and whether they are interested in that. Otherwise they'll be end up in they have to read your entire article, and sometimes editor also will reject based on if you are not giving a clear idea in starting of your review itself, means in abstract itself. So I will give you some idea about what is a review article and what is a research article. I will going to show you how it looks for people who are in post graduation stage and people who are in PhD stage. So some idea about sir, can I switch to the page? Hello. For example, okay. Are you seeing this presentation?
Yes.
So suppose I have taken this to review. So can you be able to see that in this they have written in the abstract itself what is the review about? So they have written this paper reviews some of the fuels and structure material used in advanced nuclear energy system and identify promising candidates for this system. So and so we have taken one more review this in accounting journal. This here also you can see that they have in the starting itself they have cleared that what they are going to review here. This paper reviews literature on the capital market research in accounting over the last 50 years. Rather than trying to be comprehensive, this review focuses on selecting areas and strive to be forward looking. So giving the concept and clearing out the concept earlier will make the editor who is publishing your article interested in your review, as well as the people who are reading after publishing your review who will be seeing the abstract. They will understand what is the concept of the review and whether they are interested or not. So going back to the so what should you avoid? So you should avoid jargon, because you may be thinking you are expert in this field and you are writing a review and using a complicated terminology. So you should remember that all readers are not expert in the field, and some of them are young researchers who are students reading your work. So you have to be very present the review in a simplified manner, so that even other who is not in your field also will understand what is the concept of your review. So you after writing a review, to go to the extra mile, it is highly recommended to have someone unfamiliar with your field to read your review article to make sure it makes some sense to layman audience, so that they can understand it. So then only a review article will be successful if everybody understands it. So writing a review article, you have to be strict with the review journal guidelines. So many different journals have different guidelines. We need to be very strict about the following certain what their guideline says. So if your guideline, if your review or an article, it is not in following the guidelines to how to structure the review article, what should be the reference style and all. So sometimes editorial screening, they will reject your article and you will end up in publishing, getting a rejected article from a editor itself. So what you should do is you should heavily revise your article, and you should write a first draft and heavily revise your article many times, so that give this article to many people as much as you can, so that they will give you their input, so that you can include those inputs in your review article to make it better. So if your article is rejected from a journal, so don't get disappointed. Actually, keep in mind that editors and reviewers are here to help your paper succeed, and by following their advice, you will emerge with a stronger version. Means the preview process is for to critically review your article, and they will they will give you some useful comments and critically review articles, so that if even if your article is rejected in one journal, so you can always use those reviewers' comments in the modifying your articles to make it better and publish in a another journal which may be very good, and it may end up in very much good very good article, very good journal. So coming to some coming to the few important steps in finding writing a literature review. So first step is finding a relevant research. So you should find a relevant research in your topic, and what are the tools used for this finding relevant research topic? I will go through in next few slides. And step two is log, catalog, and synthesize. And step three is actual writing of the research review. Okay, so let me go through one by one. So how do you find a research, relevant research article on your topic? So there are many ways to find a relevant research article in your topic. And these are almost similar in all the fields, all the fields, even in humanities, social studies, science, physical science, life science. This is almost similar. Okay, so you can follow this points to whatever field you are applying applying or writing a research article in whatever field you want. So this is almost applicable to all the fields, I believe. So first is to first way of finding a research article is to look it in the search engines. There are many databases, large databases, which have a lot of review articles, which have a lot of published research articles. And most in life science, the most topmost database is PubMed, and there are Google Scholar. Of course, people can researchers are heavily dependent on Google Scholar, which gives almost all the articles in your research topic. Then there is a Scopus database. Then there's Web of Science. Then is Science Direct. Then is DOAJ, that is Japanese database. And this is one of the way you can. I will give demo about this search engine, how you can go and approach what you should do to efficiently search a review, search a research article in your topic. Next is to go through university database. Of course, university and colleges having nice libraries, which are having a print. Print versions of journals, and also the online versions of journals, which they are accessible to. So few journals which are paid and maybe not accessible to a individual who is independent. If you are searching in your if you are searching in your own computer or your online by individual, you cannot search get a article which is paid version. So some of the paid versions are available in the university libraries, and some articles are which is freely available, that also you can get it from Google Scholar. And so one of the database is JGate, which is found in Indian universities. Many people, Indian institutes and universities, follow this JGate to find the articles what they are in, relevant article in their topics. And if the in this advantage of this JGate is, if the article is not full text is not available in the online JGate or anywhere else, you can always contact the author or a library to give you this. Means online in the JGate portal itself, you can this having a facility to ask a reviewer or a librarian to give that article, send that article to you so that you can refer. So this is useful in that way, and getting all the libraries are linked. This is possible because many libraries in India are linked to the JGate. So individual researchers, they deposit their research articles in this portals, so that the other university students, other institutes, students and faculties or scientists can avail this article from this portal. So next technique is snowballing. Snowballing is nothing but you are searching, finding a most relevant article in your topic. So you need not go through all the articles from the database, and there may be hundreds of articles in your topic. So you need not go through one by one and find your relevant research topic and what to write and what not to write. But snowballing is a technique which you can apply to find a one or two research article and dig their references section. So find a most suitable research article in your topic, and that will give you a fair amount of idea in the reference section what all the important references you need to search in that topic. So that goes on actually. So you find some one or two article with most relevant article, and you go to the reference section, you will find more articles, and in that, and you search those article and download those article and go through those articles reference section, and you will find you end up with a lot of articles which are most relevant to your topics. So the last techniques which I am giving here is to searching dissertation or thesis. So many students, PhD students or MSc students, they are writing excellent thesis, and they have spent lot of time in writing the review, literature review in their thesis. That will almost cover most of the literature review in their topic. So suppose you are going through those dissertations, sometimes you find most of the literature review literature for your topic, relevant literature topic, literature reviews, literature for your review articles, what you are going to write. So one of the important database which we have here in India is Shodh Ganga. So it will, so there is a UGC norms that every thesis has to be submitted in this portal, so that after you present your viva or dissertation, so the university will or a college will submit their dissertation thesis into this portal. So this is free portal, this is open access portal, anybody can access this portal and find your relevant thesis or dissertation, and you go through that dissertation, you will find most of the article in that relevant topics. Because student not only writes about the research topics in the literature review, he or she does the extensive review of the literature from the beginning, background, and a fair amount of idea is given in a literature review, which is there in the thesis or a dissertation format. So you can use those easy in your literature. So next step is to log, catalog and synthesize. So I am giving you idea about how to. So suppose you go into the literature and you end up with more hundreds of articles in your particular area. So it is very difficult to manage those 100 articles and those lists and remember those lists. you need to store it somewhere, and if there is a software and a way to store those article, you can always use those. Nowadays it is very number of article in a particular topic, it is enormous, so it is very difficult to manage those titles. And so what you can do is use some of the reference manager software like Mendeley, Zotero, and Note, so that you can download those titles what your literature reviewing, download the title which you are searching in a search engine, and log it somewhere in a software, or if you are manually doing, you need to do it in the Excel sheet or a Word file to note down all the topics and which you have searched and which is out, which you have searched in your relevant topic. That all you have to log. Otherwise, it is very difficult. You cannot keep on searching and again in the same topic, and you will end up with seeing same article, and it will create so much chaos, and it is very difficult to then go further and writing a research article. So my advice is, you use those free open access softwares. You can, some of these are, you can directly, where you're searching, suppose you're searching in PubMed Research Scholar, you can directly download the topics research article in your relevant topics into your reference manager. So it is not important that all the articles which you are logging into your reference manager or writing, it is very relevant to you. It just may be a search, it's a research result you are putting into a log, so that after that you can go through those articles and remove the unwanted articles whichever you don't want it, and further refine your whatever article you are going to use in a review. So once you are logged your information somewhere in a Excel sheet or a Word file or a reference manager, so next step is to catalog that. So cataloging is nothing but you are reading so much. Suppose you ended up in search engine, and after logging, you have gone through those articles, and you are going through those articles, and it is impossible to remember all. So you cannot remember all the articles in your, but and you may after some, because review process is not a one day process. It may take weeks and months to write a review. So you are going through the articles and you will not remember who told what. So it is important that you catalog your research, catalog your search, whatever you have searched article and whatever you read in a research review, in a research article, and make it somewhere, note down the points. It may be the best way to catalog your articles in a category is to write it down in a Excel sheet, so that you can just maybe for a title you are writing to remember what those article have told you, and what is the main important points you are gaining through those articles, so that you can remember while you are writing for a few in future. So, and you can do it in your Word file also, like this I'm shown here. Like, so you can start with the citation and identify, the citation is identifier, which article you are talking about, and important observation made in that articles, and what are the remarks, whether how we are going to use these articles in your writing a review. So next is after this process, you are tempted to write a review. Actually, you should not immediately start writing your review after cataloging. So because everything, all the information is there, so people are tempted to start writing a research review. So it will not end up in a nice review article, because this is just a list of observation what you are cataloging. So you need to digest and synthesize those whatever you have cataloged. So that can be done in many ways. You can always use a visual aid like mind mapping or a whiteboard. So whiteboard, you are so this article told this and think about it. So what is what, where will I write this observation, and how I am presenting this observation, under which subheading I am presenting this observation. All this you need to know, and you need to think about each and every article where it will fit into a structure of a review article. So next, after this only you should having spent a fair amount of time in outlining the structure, what is the review, just outline, you can outline the heading and subheading of the review article, and after that only you should go about the writing review article. So review article, when you start review article, you should not think it should be perfect in first draft itself. So you need to draft everything what you are intended to write in a first go, and make it complete so that you have a draft. It may be not a perfect article. It may be not perfect at that time, but don't worry about that. It is okay to have a first draft which is not clear in concept or something like that. So it is done is better than perfect. Okay, so. Maybe it is not perfect, but it is done. So after that process, you can, and what if you want it, make it to perfect, means in beginning itself, when you are writing an article, if you want it to be a perfect sentence, perfect paragraph, and make it a concept, make the concept perfect, it will not work. You will get stuck into, you will get stuck and you will end up in nothing, and it will make your process of review article more complex and more tedious. So better to write a draft in first go. Even it is not perfect, even it is not having all the component, it is fine. So then start making it perfect, tightening up, then go through the articles again and get some more point, and make the concept of each topic clear in multiple steps. Sometimes suppose from your first or second draft is ready, you can give it to your supervisor or give it to a friend or who is agreeing to read your articles to get their perspective, whether they are understanding the concept or not. So by this process, giving to as much of people it will make your article better. So better to give it to as much of people, and people who are having in-depth knowledge about the study, it is more the better. And then the last step is to submission to the journal or a proposal. So a review article is always not for a journal, it can be also for a proposal. So that you proposal means you are proposing to a journal, like you are writing a review article in this concept, and you can send the entire article to a journal so beforehand, so that the editor can look at it and whether this article is suitable for publishing this journal or not. So that is the idea here. It can be even if the article is not published in a journal, it can be useful for writing a research proposal for your future work, and you can have the proposal with you and go across different mentors and supervisors or a funding agency or a department head, so that you want to see, this is what I found in this literature review, this is the knowledge gap, and I'm interested to publish this, means interested to work on this area because there is a knowledge gap in this area. So this can be utilized, your review also can be utilized in this way. So So cataloging like looked like this. If you know, that was not clear in my earlier picture. So it can be that it is like citation, which article is saying. It is just by reading each one by one, you are reading the article and cataloging. Suppose here I am saying our citation about the disease prevalence in some animals, like when it was done, which year it was done, and what specimen it was collected, and what country it was done, what is the location of, so that you can make a map in for your GPS map for your literature review, and type of test used, whether it is which test it is positive and negative, like that you can make a catalog, so that it is then when you are writing next analyzing or synthesizing your it will be useful for you to frame and structure your research article. And some of the observation also will look like this. Suppose I'm comparing a male female from different research article, and it will go it will involve numbers and data. So that can be published in a systematic review. That is, they will be having statistics like our meta-analysis. If you'll have a statistic analysis to say whether your observation, what you are making from the all the articles, it is valid or not. Whether the, for in this case, males are more susceptible than females or not, like that. So meta-analysis. Now we are not looking into meta-analysis or a systematic review here. We are just talking about a review, a normal review article, which is based on a concept and current trends and what is the research gap. So this slide already, and where you can publish these review articles. Of course, you have gone through the literature review and you have got the idea and written a nice literature review, where you can publish these articles. I have some, because the audience is different field, so I have included an accounting article here and a science, life science article here. So always you can go through the journal, and there will be a section called about the articles. There you can see whether they publish a review or not, and what kind of review they publish, whether they are in your, which type of research article they have, review article they are interested in, or which type of relevant concept they are interested in. All will be there in a aim and scope of the research article. So next is suppose, and some research journal don't accept review articles. Some accept review article. Some accept review article only if you're contacting the author editor first, so that you have to send submit your article to a editor first. So he will look at your article, whether this review article is suitable for his journal or not. You can not directly submit it to the review process, pre-review process. You have to submit to the editor-in-chief first, so that he will look at and tell you whether it is he is interested to publish this article or not. That type of things you can always find it in the submission guidelines of a review. It will be there in every research journal submission guideline. How to structure your research article. In this submission guideline, you can find it in types of article section. In this section, you can find this, whether what type of research they publish. Like in, suppose here, they are given short communication, technical notes, review articles, correspondence, all these type of research article they publish. So they clearly mentioned that it has to be submitted to review editor first. So you have to look all these things first to before submission to a good review before submitting to a journal. So let us go do a demo of how to search different literature in a different search engine. So I'm taking few of the search engines, how to go approach searching a research article. So we have to use certain, there is a way of searching an article, otherwise you will end up in lot of unwanted articles. not in, and a lot of thousands of articles which you are not in, interested in, and that will create more problem in writing a review and finding a relevant research article in your topic. So in suppose you are using a PubMed which is almost covering all most of the life science journals, and I'm here given example of Scopus also. So I will give you demo how to approach it. So we need to search in a particular way. Suppose you think you are seeing here, it is given in a bracket, and there is something called in a square bracket, there is or, and, all fields, all this. Suppose you are searching an article in 3D printing and screen graft through application of 3D printing or in screen graft or research articles published in this concept. So if you see here, so it is not a simple research article 3D printing in simple search like 3D printing in screen graft. It will give you all the articles in your field, but it is not like that. So you need to put some format so that you can get what you want in your research in your literature search. Suppose you are using a PubMed, you have to use certain kind of brackets and Boolean operators to find a research article. And if you are using Scopus, if you see the difference here, they have used a normal bracket here, they have used a flower bracket or a curly bracket. And if you see this Boolean operator, this is most of the search engines will follow this. It is like and or it should be not. Sorry for that. It should be and or not. So using this Boolean operator, you can reduce your search outcome. So instead of getting thousands of articles in your search, you can end up using this Boolean operator into getting a few articles which are most relevant into your subject area or concept. So some search engines also use a wildcard. Suppose it is given in the form of hashtag. You suppose you are searching a print. So print can be in different terminology. It can be in printing, printed, printable, etc. So giving this term, you need not search printing again and printed again and printable again in a research article. If you are putting a hashtag, this symbol in after the print, you will cover almost all the forms of your whatever forms your word is going to be in the literature. So it will cover all this and it will give you a search result. So what should be a best practice in searching in PubMed article, PubMed search engine? You should be specific, no punctuation. And the difference between earlier PubMed search and now recently updated PubMed search is you need not use Boolean operator like and or not, because it has been now updated that it itself goes through all this by itself. So you need not put it. So if you put it, it may limit your search. So capitalization is not important here, and type you can just type your research box term, research term, and just click search. It will give you based on all this relevant topics in your, and using this terminology, it itself does it. Or by Google, for a Google Scholar, you need to enter this terminology. So I'm going into now demonstrate how to use this terminology. Suppose first starting, I've used PubMed. So this is a search engine for PubMed. You can you can use this search engine for searching articles in life science or science, and mostly this engine was initially designed for medical journals, but it is also covering some of the non-medical journals, suppose in life science area. So this, suppose you are typing 3D printing, suppose I have same example I will take. Skin graft. So you can see there are 44 results about the 3D printing and skin graft. So we have not used anything Boolean marker like AND or not. Even if you can use it, but the new PubMed does it for you. Okay, you need not use it. It automatically does for you. So here I can put this Boolean operator. So it, same result it is showing. Suppose suppose we can use other Boolean operator like OR. So I want the result like screen graft or 3D printing in suppose bone. So 3D printing in bone. So nowadays they are doing 3D printing in bone technology, synthesizing a bone for fractured individuals. So let us put that topic here. So what it does is, see, so it is searching 3D printing and also searching screen graft or bone. So
sorry to interrupt,
giving both of this result, so together, so you can see the
Vinod articles
it has been increased to
Vinod.
It's more articles. So if I search only bone, so there are 2400 articles. So other articles were about the skin grafting. So it is giving application of 3D printing in bone as well as skin
grafting. Dr. Vinod, so
if you see the advanced search, telling you to not use Boolean operators here is, so you can just type 3D printing or bone, 3D print or bone. It will give you search results. And if you go to advanced, so it will give you what it has been searching. So you can see in this field, what all it has been searching. Hello, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Oh, okay. Screen is not visible.
You have to stop sharing this and share your Firefox, whichever search engine. Stop sharing this slide and share your Firefox screen.
Okay.
Google Chrome or Firefox.
Yeah. Yeah, now you can see. Hello, are you able to see now the screen?
Yeah.
Yes,
we can see. We can see.
Okay.
You can start from first, I guess.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I will go to first. So I was talking about in presentation. You might have seen the. I was talking about, suppose we are searching 3D printing and application of 3D printing in screen grafting. Suppose you are writing a review about, or if you want to see what are the articles published in 3D printing related to screen grafting. So 3D printing having many applications in physics and printing some equipments and all. But we are not interested in that. We are interested in specific topic like 3D printing in screen grafting. Okay, so how it is useful for in a burn patient, how we can use 3D printing for grafting the screen. So if you suppose you click 3D printing, so you see there are 11,000 articles. So you are not interested in 3D printing about all these articles. You are interested in specific results. So you are interested in articles about the screen grafting. So you need to write screen grafting. Yeah. So when you put screen grafting, it will say only 43 research articles is about the screen grafting. So you can see here there are many options in this, which will like year wise. You can also search year wise. Suppose I want to search what is the article published in 2018. It will give you the 2018 article. Suppose I want to search range. Okay, so range of article from 2011 to 2020. So like that, I can reduce the range of article. Suppose I want to study the articles published in last 5 years only. So in that case, there are 33 articles published in this topic in last 5 years. So this is that, and for which all topic full text is available. If you click this, so you can find it. There are 7 articles which having the full text article. Suppose you want to study the abstract here itself. So it gives you all the articles having abstract. So that you can see most of the articles having abstract here. So that also you can see here.
Please skip it from there. No, he's in 18th slide.
So next is, what are the article types? So you can see whether it is a book or a document or a clinical trial or a meta-analysis or a randomized control trial or a review article. Suppose we can see whether somebody has written a review about screen grafting and 3D printing. You can find it here. So there are 14 results which is talking about the screen grafting and 3D printing, and which all ranges in 2016 to 2020. These 14 articles are talking about screen grafting and 3D printing. So this is the how you are searching. So if you have, as I told, like Boolean operators, the and or not can be used here, but I am advising not to use here in a PubMed, because PubMed is already doing for you. Means it has improved from the previous version, and it is automated almost, like and it has improved on the presentation of your search result. Suppose here we have searched as 3D printing and screen grafting. So let us look at what it has searched in the PubMed. So it is not only it is searching 3D term. Okay, we have given 3D, but it is also searching 3D, three dimension in the word format. Okay, it has expanded the abbreviation 3D into expanded format, and it is also searching or printing, or three dimensional only, or three dimensional printing. So the article always will not have a particular terminology what you are searching. It may be not always they say 3D printing, but they will they say the printing in 3D or like that. So it all has to be covered. So it is giving some idea, which is searching all those possibilities and giving you a result. So it is automatically done. So you need not put any Boolean operators here. So it is automatically putting the Boolean operators like or, not, or and everything. So it is searching even skin, transplantation. Even we did not put transplantation in our search. It is putting transplantation, screens transplantation, screen grafting. Okay. So all those will be covered. So my advice is, when you're probably searching an article in PubMed, you need not use the search and full Boolean operator. You can avoid those and just type it. Maybe specific word you need to type, but not the sentence. Just for example, here we have typed 3D printing and screen grafting. So it will give you all, it will search all the articles and it will give you a result in most sophisticated manner. Suppose you want to change this. So you can further take this from here, copy this and paste here. And change. You don't want to see, suppose I want to see screen grafting in only in titles, title abstract. So this screen grafting and 3D may be mentioned in your throughout the articles. It may be, it is written like all, it is here given in all field. So you want not the all field, you need more specific. You need only the articles which are mentioning this screen grafting in title or abstract. So if there is this terminology they are present in title or abstract, that that will be more specific to your research. So you will find more specific article for your relevant topic, rather than searching a terminology which is present in somewhere written in a discussion or somewhere else, which way you will be ending up reading those article but wasting your time. So let us, what you will do to search a particular topic in a title or abstract, you need to type TI or AB, TIAB. If you type TIAB, it will search only this terminology in the title and abstract. So we are changing all this into title and abstract. It is not searching in all field, means it is all field means it is searching in everywhere in the paper. Suppose we are adding everywhere. Now let us search the, add this in the query box, and this comes under an advanced search. Okay, you are more refining your search rather than simply putting the terminals. Suppose you are putting this, I have not changed everything. So you see there is only 12 result. I think it is same, giving same. So you need to refine more. So I will try one more thing. Let us search for a, giving you an example. I will give you 3D. Printing and screen grafting. Okay. So that's in graph input or 3D print output. So I need this terminology in only in title or abstract. Let us search this. You see, earlier what we searched was 30 articles. Okay. Now we are searching. So, in title abstract, it's not finding any articles. Suppose we put the wildcard asterisk here.
Why they are not consulted? How they are? Why they are not consulted?
You see, 8 result has found. So what this asterisk does is, it will see for you, not even print, it will see for printing, printable, whatever the terminology it expands. So that is the thing. So here screen graft also, grafting, grafted, everything will come. So we are looking for title and abstract. So the terminology should be in title as well as abstract. So whichever article had this title, terminology, title and abstract, it is giving you here. So this is about the literature search in the PubMed. Okay. So this, suppose I skin graft. Suppose I know how to use not here. Suppose I am using not here. So you see, all this has to be capitalized. Your Boolean operator has to be capitalized. So not means I don't want the article saying the suppose burn victims, burn victims. Suppose for example, you see, okay, so burn. So I'll search. So it is giving 5 result only. So I want screen grafting, but not in a burn patients or burn, which is the study which is dealing with the burn. So like this, you can pinpoint your relevant literature, so that now you have all these things and relevant article in your terminology what you have put. And suppose it is 5 article, you can use this article to review your literature. Okay. So next is I'll use the same thing and demonstrate in the Google Scholar as well. I think I have overshifted the time. I will finish it soon. So this is one more search engine. It will cover most of the article, any field. It is relevant to any field, not even only science, life science. It will cover most of the article in all the fields. So you need to search here also. So let us search same terminology. As I told, there you need not put the Boolean operators and it will give you all the option. Here you need to put, there is no option here. You need to put all the Boolean operators. Here you can use the hashtag. Graft. So it say 23,000 articles are there in this topic. Then you can use the other not topic. You don't want that. You don't want this. I suppose that how I explained in the PubMed, same version. So you will get more refined articles in your less number of articles in the, this is more 23,000 because there are, it covers more journals and there are repetition of these topics also. So be not that there is a 23,000 article present. It is maybe way much lesser than that, but there's those maybe in multiple clones, maybe it will be there in the multiple format. So here also you have the options to search date wise. You can search by since 2019, 2016. So in custom range also you put 2016 to 2019. So year wise you can have the search result. So you have the article 2016 to 19, what are the article published. So it can be used and it can be refined more using the terminology what you are putting in. So specific terminology and not or if you put and more get what are specific terminology, you will end up in lesser article to review. So if you are not knowing this, it will end up in 20, you have to look at 13,000 articles one by one. It is huge task. It is not, maybe you end up in maybe few hundreds of articles. That is fine. Hundreds are better than thousands of articles. So one more thing, in the PubMed, you can log into the PubMed. You can see. Sorry. You can see it is logged in. You can always log in to PubMed and save this. You can email this result to your mail or save this email. It will be present for 6 months, so that you can come back and have the titles again read by one by one. It's having that option, and you can create alert also. So this whatever search, this alert, you can put it in the alert section And suppose it will give you email every, suppose you can set alerts, suppose a new article published in 2000, now suppose in future new article published, it will give you an alert. It will send you emails, email relevant to this topic, relevant to this topic to your email itself. So you can know that what are the article publishing in my relevant topic which I have searched earlier. And I can, suppose you are building a review article, it will be useful for that. So this is about searching. Cataloging, that entire difference. So cataloging can be directly your search result can be directly imported to the a reference manager. Suppose you can see a Mendeley here, so you can sign in. So what it does is, it will entire search, it will get into the software. So you need not know to make a notes and note each and every topic, author name, everything. It is not necessary. So if you are using this software, it will directly put all these references in your software so that you can, without network, you can access in your desktop whenever you want and wherever you want, it can be accessed. This Mendeley, that is the next session which I am taking, the next session which will be detailed in depth how to use this Mendeley software for managing your research result and managing your PDF and how to cite references in your research article. So next, I'll go back to the presentation mode. There are a lot to cover here, but I think lack of time I'm not covering here. So going into, I think you have gone through. So next part is avoiding plagiarism. You have written the review, okay, and knowingly, unknowingly, there will be a material which is, it is another important topic, but we are not covering here. So if you have written a review, you can always go through online. Online portal, how to check plagiarism, what is plagiarism. Plagiarism is nothing but you cannot copy somebody else's sentence and make it yours. You need to cite them properly and you need to write it in a different way. So you cannot copy the sentence from a review and make it your own a literature article and make it your own. It is not a collection of copy paste. It is if you are doing the the journal will find you and find the means it has been copied and they will not accept your article and they will send back to you to that it is having the plagiarism. So you cannot copy that. It is an entirely different topic we are not discussing here, but you need to check if you are after writing your review. You need to always check. Everybody has to check. Okay, there are software in the online which are paid and unpaid. Software which you can check whether what you are writing is matching with some other author's publication or not. If it is matching, you can change always how to, you can change in different way, you can write it in different manner. To avoid the plagiarism so that your article is unique in certain way and it get published. Next is beware of fake journals. Okay, there is actually in 2017, Nature published a report like India's most articles published in fake journals. So what are these fake journals? Predatory or fake journals is they will take money and publish your article without a pre-review process. Means it doesn't undergo the experts. So your article is not given to experts to review, whether critical review, whether your article is well written, it is relevant to topic or it is what you are suggesting in your article is true or wrong, or it is a new concept is fake or not. So it cannot be they done because without a pre-review. So some journals are exploiting the students and faculties and other scientists so that they without pre-review process they are publishing their articles. So that is not acceptable. When this article was published in Nature and then UGC undergone a rigorous process of removing this article, okay, then in 2019 they came up with UGC CARE reference list. So earlier almost like 80% of the 80% of the articles which are published in from India were found to be having in predatory journals. That was very bad, and then they analyzed entirely, rehauled the overall system, and they removed and reviewed the. There was an extensive review by a committee, and most of the UGC recommended journals, which were earlier in 2017, were removed. Almost like 4,000 journals were removed. So my advice is don't fall into the predatory journal things and lose your process. And they are now UGC is not considering this. If you are published in these journals, not considering this article as your publication, you cannot submit to UGC for a job or for an award or some recognition at all. They are not accepting these kind of predatory journals in to avoid the, because it will create more false data. And you might have heard the COVID review about the hydroquinone that created so much havoc, and then they removed the article from the net. So basically you need to avoid the predatory journals. They will be sending you mail that we will publish you with this much money, and if you keep pay me 10,000-2,000, we'll publish your article. It may be published also in very short time, but remember that it is not a pre-reviewed journal, and it is not accepted anywhere else in normal system. So you will be end up in wasting your time and money into publishing into bad journals. So you see there's 88% of the UGC journal whitelist were predatory. This was done when I think 2018. Then they have rectified this list. Now you can find the or UGC care list. You can go there and find the journals. It is all the journals are there in arts and humanity, science journal and social science. All type of different fields of journals are available. So you can go and check the list to where you can publish your articles. So this is about the review article. I don't know how much I able
to use that UV visible only chemistry.
Yeah, how much I have covered this in this review article, whether I'm able to communicate it properly or not. But next session will be. Or I will give you some introduction about the session. It is using the Mendeley software. It is purely about the managing your references and citing article. I think it is nothing to do with the concept. It is applicable to anybody, any young researcher. I think it is applicable to all the whatever the position they are. They need to, nowadays it's very necessary to use. Otherwise, it is very difficult to manage PDFs or articles in a normal folders or something. You need to categorize, log those articles into some kind of software. Some are free, some are not. But I will be next presentation will be on this kind of software, which will make your life easy. For the researcher who are beginners and who are who are published lot of articles, they can also use this software for the making the referencing and making the search very easy, because these kind of softwares are particularly designed for helpful for researchers to help to reduce the writing time and reduce the rigorous process of printing articles and keeping and one by one marking, or having a different PDFs, or downloading different PDFs, articles, same article you will be downloading multiple times and keeping, and you don't know where you kept. All these problems are solved by this kind of softwares. So I think that will be in my next session. So I will conclude. I think I have taken more time. So thank you. Thank you for listening. Any questions you can ask.
Thank you, Dr. Vinod.
Yes, thank you.
Over the last 90 minutes, you took us through the way of how important yet simple a review research is. The session was highly insightful, as always. Now the session is open for questions. Yeah, I find a question from Dr. V. Balamurugan. He asks, it's a quite a lengthy question. He asks, who can write the review articles? What level of minimum expertise one author should have before submitting a review article to high impact peer review journals? And for doing so, what do you recommend? What number do you recommend as far as the reference is concerned?
Okay. Yeah, this was a very relevant question. I wanted to cover this, but somehow missed in the presentation. Yes, this is, everybody has this doubt, and there are myths about this concept, like who can write a review. Okay, so few people think only experts can write a review, and there is a concept like at least you need to publish 10 articles, a research article, to write a proper review, or you are eligible for review. And that may be, or it can be also thought of like some people will say it is like you should have minimum 10 years of experience to write a review. Okay, and there is also other concept like it is all true, but in its own way. And I as per my observation, as per my research, means I'm researching all this, how who can write a review from past few days, and I found that anybody can write a review actually. So even undergrad can write a review. Actually, all the time we write a literature review as for a dissertation purpose. A MSc can write a review in a dissertation. He writes a review. It is a thesis contains a literature review, and a PhD scholar writes a review. And even young scientists who have just joined and they are proposing something, they are writing a review. So all of it is true. Okay, all what I've mentioned here, even undergrads, graduate, post-graduation, and faculty, and expert who is having 10 years, more than 10 years experience, and who is published more than 10 research articles, we are having more experience. It all this this is true, but thing is there will be a difference between suppose a undergrad is writing a review or a master's students is writing a review, and an expert who is having more than 10 years experience who is writing a review. So there will be intricate knowledge which an expert provides that will not be found in a student who are writing a first time review, or a PhD scholar who is writing a review. So, but said that, it is, you know, sometimes a PhD scholar will find a important observation which expert may not see. So that is also possible, or an undergrad can. I have seen people, juniors and all those students or friends who have written a review in BSc also, or who have written review in MSc also. It is published in reputed journals, and it has given a way for them to propose some research, propose a topic in a research, because using that review they have proposed a research topic to do a PhD or do a abroad program or getting a postdoc. All this I've seen this. So there is no restriction as who can write a review. There is no restriction actually, but thing is it varies with the outcome. So the undergrad or a postgrad cannot see what expert can see So in-depth knowledge he cannot provide. So an expert can give in-depth knowledge, but yeah, no, it is everybody can write a review. But undergrad or postgraduate student always have the their prayers or superiors to support them, and they can write a review and give it to the superiors, their lecturers or their professors, so that they can add that component of expert. So yes, anybody can write a review. And number of articles, next question about the number of articles. A minimum article would be, suppose mine, I've attended few like the seminars, and they say minimum is one article you cannot write a review. That is not a review, that's just an opinion. You are telling about the opinion. You can also publish that type of article, like you can read an article and comment about it and publish it into the same journal or a different journal about so and so article is published. This article, this is observation made and this can be done like that, you can publish. But a review article cannot be written with one article. It has to be more than one. So sometimes you can find a review article, research topic, you can cover it as more than 100 relevant article you can find, which you can write a review. But sometimes a topic is so new that you cannot find a review article more than 5 or 10. So that case, what you will do? So that case, you need to write it with that amount of articles which you are, maybe if you find 5 articles, you need to use those articles to write a review. You can use it. So my answer is more than 3. And different experts have a different opinion on this. They say more than 5, some say more than 10. I think it depends on the topic. Okay, so more recent topic or more relevant topic, or more, nobody has touched the topic in research, that also can be written a review and made it a proposal which can be utilized by the youngsters or who want to do the research on that topic. They can find, utilize those review and further use those review and further take up the research. So that is my answer. Thank you for the questions. Next.
Yeah. Next question. Kipar, I would like to ask, how to identify whether a journal is...
It was not clear if I am able, yeah, got that thing. You have asked, how do I identify that is predatory or not, right?
Because Balamuran is easy to approach.
Yes, that was your question, sir. I didn't hear that clearly.
Yes, Vinod, sir. Yes, Vinod, sir. You can answer.
So, fortunately, UGC has rectified this problem, and they have did a comprehensive review. Many different faculties from different universities, experts have sat through the process of selecting those journals and making it as a list. So as I've shown you, I think you can see the screen, right? I think earlier what I've talked about. Yeah, can you see the screen, sir? So they have, UGC have
made, yes, sir.
Thank you. UGC have made a list about, it was published in 2019. Earlier list was having almost 3,000, 4,000 journals, which having fake journals. They were all those, they have refined the articles, list of articles, list of journals, and they made it a list which can, you can find it as in the form of UGC Care. You can go find it in the UGC website. There you can click this and you can find this articles related to your field, and there you can, sorry, not article, it is journals related to your field. If it is there in that list only, you choose better, that is option. But sometimes the UGC list is going through, the reviewers are going through, even there is a possibility of getting a fake journal which they can remove the in the next session. Maybe next year they will remove some of the journals. So better to go through a Scopus list. Better. So Scopus list or webs PubMed list, which are there in PubMed or which are there in Web of Science. These kind of journal collection database you can search. If there is your journal is in that list, you can always go through. So you, for now, you can search UGC list. So many of the that is because they have reviewed it extensively and put this list, and they were reviewing it as the. And there is one more problem in the. Even if you, there is, it is there in a, it is authenticated journal and very well reputed journal, there is problem of clone. So I have given you here. So there is a clone journal. So it will look like it will having the same title, like suppose brand. You will see different brand which having same brand name. Like suppose in this case Adidas. But some are fake. It will look like same thing, but it is fake. So in the case of it, he looks like Obama, but he is not Obama. But it is look like. But that can be also. People will get into trap in this kind of journal also. So you need to find the articles in the particular database. You need not. If you are going to a Google search for that article, you may find it a clone journal, clone versions also. So. You beware of that. Better to go into the UGC list and find it there itself. There is an option to go to. They are having a link to go to the particular journal. So it will take you to the web page, which is going to the particular journal. You need not go and search in Google. And sometimes it happens that clone version will be there. They will be asking you money, and you will be published, and the author will be. Then you will find out, and the author will be cheated in this case, and he will be thinking my article is in the reputed journal, but it may be published in fake journal. That may happen. There are many cloned versions of many reputed journals, big journals. So beware of that. Please don't put it into those journals, and go through the UGC list and all those which are list. There are guidelines how which are fake journals, which are not, how to identify in the UGC group, that care group only. So that web page you can go and search what is the guideline, how I can avoid those predatory journal or cloned journal. So to before publishing it, so it is very important. So please go to. So please, thank you.
Yeah, the next question is asked by Mr. Abhishek. He intends to ask, what is the value difference between a review article and a research article?
Okay.
Value difference.
Value, actually, in my opinion, a review article has a more value because, it, of course, both in same in different way has a more important, their own importance, because a research article is your own observation. Okay, so you have done the study and you are coming up with the result and you are giving a conclusion. So that is with your own methodology, your own scenario, whatever you have followed, and you are getting a particular result and conclusion. But that may not applicable to some other researcher who is doing a research in same topic in some other place. So, and repeatability. So repeatability won't be there. Suppose same thing somebody repeats, it may be not, they may not end up in same conclusion because there may be some error in your research article. So how these are rectified? So in a review article, all these aspects are analyzed. Suppose only one article is saying, suppose for example, one article is saying females are more susceptible to this disease and the male, and rest of like 10 or 20 articles are saying opposite. So something wrong with this one first article. So there is in that particular place, there is actual scenario. Maybe the author is right and his methodology is right. He has found out the particular result as be perfect. But it may be different from this other studies in some way, which can be discussed. So for a reader who is reading a review, will come to know all this aspect. Okay, so majority of journals says these things, but a particular journal say this thing means this opposite. But this having a point, this journals having a point, maybe it's due to these factors it is giving. So for my opinion, the value of both are there needs to and research article needs to be there to review. Okay, without research article you cannot review anything. So it is more important, research both are more important. The research article should be there, and there should be authors who are reviewing this research article and telling coming up with new new conclusion about all these research articles, and coming up knowledge gap to provide to go way forward. So that is important. So in my mind, both are important. There will be research articles, and there will be, even suppose it is very, review articles are very important in policy making. So a government or a institutions or a particular organization is trying to bring out some interventions or bring out some change, where they can find this information. They cannot go through each and individual article and then come out, oh, this is working, this is not working. In that case, review article will help. So to make a guidelines or make a intervention strategy, suppose this suppose in COVID, example like COVID, wearing a mask, they know wearing a mask, it will help because of the literature review we previously published and a lot of article published. We know that wearing of mask will prevent exposure to it will prevent the exposure of different viral disease. So that how we know this this is the intervention to follow. This is based on the review article. So author should always go into finding out whether there is review article in particular topic or not. And if there is a gap, suppose 5 years gap is there and nobody has published a review article in particular topic, you can go forward and take the previous review article and update it so that it will be useful for next generation. So in my opinion, both are important. And in the government point of view, policy maker point of view, the review article is very much important, and it saves a lot of time and money for making a policy making or an action strategy. Okay. I think that gives you some idea about it. Thank you.
We will take just a few more questions. So Guru Prasad would like to ask, say suppose if someone communicates, is it okay first of all to communicate the same work to two different journals? If at all I do so, and if the waiting time, the acceptance time is quite longer, is there any cancelling penalty fees that some journal will apply? Say if I withdraw after 4-5 months time, if I withdraw, will they apply a penalty fees on that?
No. This is not possible. Actually, it is considered as unethical to submit the same article to different journal at the same time. That is very that is considered as malpractice and unethical. That should not be done. Actually, in the submission process also, itself, there is a criteria. They will ask whether it is submitted to some other journal or whether it is in pre-review process. Of course, it cannot be avoidable. Journals takes time, pre-review takes time. You submit a journal and journal sends to expert in that field for a pre-review process. Our reviewers go through your literature, take many days, even months sometimes, to review, and sometimes editor is not satisfied with the initial reviewers. He may send to some other reviewer after maybe suppose you say 3 months, 4 months to get a more expert opinion. So it will take time. So that doesn't mean like we can submit to some other journal and wait for it. And if it is, if that is found, and if, because sometimes same articles may be sent to different same reviewer. Suppose different journal. Suppose you are submitted to through two different journal. So both the journal send the article to same reviewer. In that case, reviewer will find out like these two are coming for different. The article has submitted, the author has submitted in different journal at same time, and that will consider as malpractice, and the implication will be serious. Sometimes they will blacklist you or something. It will be a violation of some rules, and there are more implication to that. So should be avoided. So it is like a proposal. Proposals also cannot be submitted to different grant agency at a time. You need to change the approach and submit. You can submit it, but your same article cannot be submitted to different journal at a time. There is a modern approach to this. Nowadays there is concept called preprint. It is called preprint. There are many preprint journals. So you can submit those articles preprint. It means you can in the preprint platforms before submitting to some journals. So journals will be willing to accept preprints so that your article is out there in the online, but it's not pre-reviewed. So those preprint journals, you can article after the preprint publication. So whenever you want, you can publish those articles. Suppose you think like my research, somebody can copy, or they can come up with same result before me, before I publish, they publish. If you feel that for a research article, you can submit that into preprint version. There are many preprint versions like BioXRF or ChemRF or all this kind of different preprint version. And there are preprint version platform for review articles also. So even before completion of the review, you can submit the draft. Okay, so you can submit the draft, then modifying, you can submit the different versions of, suppose you are building a review, you can submit the initial draft, then keep on modify afterwards so that people will know that you are doing this work and you have submitted this work, and they will not do the same thing. So they know this review is online, this review is somebody has written, so I cannot write the review again. There are some websites where you can register your review process earlier, and title, and so that nobody can, some other author don't waste on time on reviewing those same title. So they will know, going through those websites, they can know that somebody else is writing this review. So I will avoid, and maybe I'll write in different aspects. So that again, same coming to the emphasizing that we cannot submit the same article into two different, that will be considered as malpractice, and it is highly unethical. So because the pre-review process, journals spend more, editors spend, and journals spend more time in sending into pre-review. And if you are in, suppose you have sent it to two journals, one is reputed, one is not so reputed. If it is accepted in reputed journal, you cancel the unreputed journal. So they will be pissed off, and it will, serious action can be taken against you. So please avoid submitting into multiple journals at the same time. So after you get rejected, you can submit, of course. You can prepare the, this you can do. You can, suppose you feel that it can be rejected, or I need not spend time on again formatting the list. That's where the second session will help you to easily format the article into new journal, because journal formatting is itself takes time. It takes days to take, again, rearrange references, rearrange the format, title, abstract, how they want, our number of wording and all, it will different. So this and all will take times. So what you can do is, you can make the title, make the article in different journal format and keep it. Do not submit it. If in case the earlier article which you have submitted is rejected, then you can submit it to, because you already made it into different. This is where the reference manager software comes to be really handy, because multiple rejection will be there. So we need to change different style, different articles. This will article style referencing and all those things. This reference manager will take care of that. See, even in from a single click, you can do that. So if you click that, it will change automatically to different journal format, so that you can publish that, submit that into a different journal. So that can be done. Thank you. Okay, I think that answers your question. Thank you, Guru.
Yeah, I don't see any more questions in the chat box. So I think we can go ahead and wind up for the day. And before we close, I would like to invite Dr. Shiva, Associate Professor, Department of Microbiology, to propose word of thanks.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of Department of Microbiology and Research Committee, Indian Academy Degree College, Autonomous, Bangalore, I take this opportunity to propose word of thanks for the session one of the webinar series titled Integration. At the outset, I thank the resource person, Dr. K. Vinod Kumar, for accepting our invitation and for giving elaborate informations on searching of articles with demo and review paper preparation in different subjects. I extend our heartfelt gratitude to the management for the support to organize this webinar successfully. I would like to thank Dr. E. Jerome Xavier, principal, for his encouragement and continuous support. Sincerely, I thank all the participants for attending this session very actively. Few announcements for the participants before concluding the session. Attendance link for the session one has put in the chat box of Zoom as well as in Facebook Live. Kindly fill the form and submit. The link will be active for next 15 minutes. Second session of the webinar is on 8th September 2020 at 2 p.m. Further details of the session will be shared to the registered email ID. Thank you.
So as announced, thank you, ma'am. So as announced, kindly be with us on 8th September 2020 at 2 p.m. onwards. Until then, bye from us. Stay safe and sound. Thank you, Vinod.
Thank you. I need to add some more. Can I tell?
Yeah, please go ahead.
To participant, if you feel that it is, you did not understand anything from this, whatever I presented, it is okay to not, but at least you got the, at least you have some little knowledge about where is what and what is what. Means you need not, you may be not getting all the concept out of you, it may not be useful to you to immediately start writing a review article. Maybe not that in the most of the cases, but it may, I wanted to set some information to at least make me familiar with the concept and things, so that everybody, I think anybody can write a review and they can publish an article. So don't hesitate to go. There are now tons of online courses, free courses about this particular aspect of how to write a review, how to cite, how to search article in journal, how to search article in search engine, where you can find the PDFs. Suppose you don't have a full articles, where you can find full articles. All these, there are extensive tons of courses and videos available online. So you can always go through. It is a slow process. In a single day, we cannot start writing a review and come up with some great publication. It is a time-bound process. It takes time. Maybe you can, because I understand most of your faculties, there is no time. But somehow slowly you can use this whatever techniques I will be going to demonstrate, whatever few little time I have demonstrated or going to demonstrate in next session. Next session will be, I think, fully demo. There we need we will entirely go on demo, and I will make sure that it will have a complete in-depth knowledge about how to approach articles, and it will be purely about technique, how which can avoid you, save you a lot of time and efforts which you usually take into consideration when you write a manually write a review article. These softwares will help you in reducing the time by large extent. So I believe like all of you will join me in the next session, so that I'll try to make it more useful to you, so that you can understand the concept, at least how to how to use the software to reduce your time in searching, as well as managing your PDFs, and as well as citing the literature and changing into suppose you are publish in different journal, so you can single click, you can change the reference style and all. So I will focus more on that concept and demo. Okay, so thank you all. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you, sir, organizers, for allowing me. I am deeply honored for giving you this first session. So hopefully the next session is fruitful. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Vinod. Thank you. See you on 8th.
8th. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
See you all. Bye. Bye.
Thank you, Vinod, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.